Good evening. This is Minister Isaac coming to you today with a little words of wisdom, so to speak. In Proverbs chapter 12, in verse 13, we read these words from the Tanakh. Hope deferred makes the heart sick, but when desire is fulfilled, it is a tree of life. There's an old saying, it goes, to conquer a nation, first you must conquer their hope. In other words, if you can conquer people's hope, you can conquer them. And that's what it means by hope deferred makes the heart sick. Today, my friend, there's many things trying to steal our hope, trying to conquer our hope. Bad news, bad economy, problems in life, and many other things try to steal our hope and take it away, in which in turn makes us sick. But today I want to encourage you to keep your hope. Remember, hope deferred makes you sick. So if you can keep your hope, you can keep yourself healthy. And desire is a tree of life. If you feel like somebody's coming against your hope, pulling you down and pulling you down, just remember, keep that desire. Keep going forward in the Torah of our God. Verse 13 says, whosoever despises the word shall perish by it, but he that fears or reverence the commandments shall be rewarded. There is our hope. If we keep the commandments of our God and stay true to Him, then our hope will be filled up. Our hope will be full, and we will be rewarded. Remember, that is the desire, our reward. We will be rewarded because we keep the hope in our God. The Torah and the commandments of God is everything for us. We have to listen to His word. We have to take it to our hearts, and we have to apply it to our very lives. That's why it says it's so important that we must keep our hope. We must keep our joy. We must keep our happiness and our gladness in our heart, because everything out there in this world is trying to steal our hope to conquer us. Remember, if you can get the hope of the people, you can conquer the nation. But when desire comes and that hope ignites inside of people, it's like a flame in the forest. It spreads. Let the Torah start a flame in your heart to keep reviving and reviving and reviving that hope that's in us. And we will be encouraged and we will be strong in our Lord and our God. That's the good news today, that we can have hope. Hope will keep us healthy. Hope will keep us encouraged. Hope will keep us going from day to day, week to week, year to year, no matter what. Because we have hope in the God of Israel, and we keep His commandments. Are we perfect? No, my friend, we're not perfect. But we're striving every day, to keep the commandments of our God. That's our goal. That's what we set out to do every day, is keep the commandments of God. And every day we grow closer and closer and closer. Every day His commandments washes over us and cleans us and leads us. And our hope grows and our confidence grows in the Lord our God. Remember, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. And we shall love the Lord our God with all our heart, with all our soul, and with all our strength. That's the key, my friend. That's the key to having a relationship with our Heavenly Father, is love Him with all our heart, and all our soul, and all our strength. That's what we have to do. We have to encourage ourselves. Keep hope alive, no matter the circumstance, no matter the situation, no matter how dark it becomes around us. 1,000 may fall at our right hand, and 10,000 may fall at our left hand, but the plague shall not come nigh us. Why? Because we have a steadfast hope in our God. So I want to encourage you today. Hope. Let hope stay alive. Keep hope alive in your life. Remember, if you keep the commandments, you strive to follow the Lord our God, you shall be rewarded. This is Minister Isaac with Karaite Judaism. If you have any questions, email us. If you got any questions about conversion, email us also. We're here to help you. Remember, the God of Israel loves you.